In Africa, before the AIDS crisis, you never had this many orphans. So the fiber is completely broken. People, instead of working, they are taking care of the sick. And many, as you said, don't have anyone left.
It is so unique. It is a model that you can take to other communities and villages that have been impacted by HIV/AIDS, poverty, illness, because the school is not only beginning to lift up the community and giving the community options, it is providing a source of education, feeding kids, getting the whole community involved.
Most grandmothers have raised their children. After their children are grown and die of AIDS, now they have to come back and raise grandchildren. They are the heroes who are not praised by anybody. Millions of grandmothers in Africa that take care of more than 14 children whose parents have died, they go to bed every day knowing some children are going to die.
As I reviewed some of the film footage and pictures, I noticed a boy in a wheelchair. Alan was asked, "Is there anything you would like? Do you have a wish?" Alan said, quietly and humbly, says, "I just want to be able to stand up." I said to Jackson, I said, "Well, all the kids seem to be able to walk or be ambulatory, but what's wrong with Alan?" He says, "I'm not sure what's wrong with Alan, but I think he has a condition that can be helped." It was arranged, and Alan did go to the capital city and saw a wonderful doctor, Dr. Sebuliba. And he said, if he doesn't come soon, if he doesn't get this operation, nobody's going to be able to help him. He'll be a cripple forever.
Because after, you know, 13 years just crawling around the ground, you start thinking nothing's going to change. But all of a sudden, you just started seeing, I can do things that I never even imagined.